हेलो।
कोरोना वायरस या COVID-19 से आज पूरा देश लड़ रहा है, पर याद रहे हमें बीमारी से लड़ना है, बीमार से नहीं। उनसे भेदभाव ना करें, उनकी देखभाल करें और इस बीमारी।
हेलो।
प्रभुदेव,
यस शिवादित्य, यू हैड अ क्वेश्चन रिगार्डिंग सोलर इक्लिप्स। व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन?
वेल, आई वांटेड टू आस्क अबाउट सिग्निफिकेंस, बट आई थिंक यू हैव ऑलरेडी स्पोकन अबाउट इट इन द टॉक, सो आई विल लिसन टू दैट। बट मोर देन दैट, आई वांटेड टू आस्क इफ लुकिंग एट द सोलर इक्लिप्स इज स्पिरिचुअली डेट्रीमेंटल और इट इज हार्मफुल इन एनी वे। आई मीन ऑफ कोर्स इफ यू लुक एट इट विद you know, their eyes, then it is definitely, it might be harmful to the eyes, but I'm asking spiritually. And what is this significance, if you can just shortly elaborate?
See, the solar, like all eclipses, and there are certain events in the universe, they are called parvakalas or special occasions.
Okay.
Okay, solar eclipse is a parvakala or a special occasion.
Okay.
Our ancestors identified many of the cosmic events as parvakala. పర్వకాల ఇట్స్ నాట్ పర్వ మీన్స్ స్పెషల్ విశేష ఓకే వై దే ఆర్ పర్వకాల బికాస్ ఇట్స్ ఆస్పీషియస్ సంథింగ్ హ్యాపన్స్ ఇన్ ది కాస్మాస్ అండ్ ఇండివిజువల్ ఈస్ అ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది కాస్మాస్ సో సంథింగ్ హ్యాపన్స్ విదిన్ అస్ ఆల్సో వెన్ ది సంథింగ్ హ్యాపన్స్ ఇన్ ది అవుట్ సైడ్ ఓకే సో ఇట్స్ ద ప్రిన్సిపల్ ఈస్ యద్ బ్రహ్మాండే తద్ పిండాండే వాట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ ద కాస్మాస్ హ్యాపన్స్ ఇన్ ది ఇండివిజువల్ ఆల్సో మైక్రో కాస్మ ఆల్సో What is cosmos happens in the microcosm. Okay, so there is a cosmic event and into related microcosmic event. Microcosmic event is called spiritual, and cosmic event is what you call a solar eclipse.
Okay.
Okay. Now looking at a solar eclipse is definitely harmful to the eyes because ultraviolet rays will come. Okay.
Yes.
So it's definitely harmful. That's a physical event, but the ancestors called. This parvakala or special events are the good time to meditate or very special events for meditation.
Okay.
Okay. Any activity, any spiritual activity you undertake during parvakala is considered as very auspicious or much more intense than other times.
All right.
Why that is intense? Because this you know very well that during moon full moon and during amavasya or the new moon,
energy surge.
Yes. Energy surge. Okay.
Yes.
The solar eclipse time also there's some energy surge happens within the individual.
Okay.
Okay, that's one thing. Then the more than that, there's a significance of the cosmos and individual. The cosmic level, sun, okay, what you call a sun at the cosmic level is at the microcosmic level, Atma. In the self, spirituality is Atma, the self.
Okay.
So this is called Atma Surya, inner self, inner sun. Okay, in the cosmos, the sun. Okay, the moon in the cosmos is called mind in the human being. The mind is moon is a representation of mind.
Mind, subconscious mind is it?
All mind, a total mind.
All mind.
Okay.
And sun represents the self.
Atma, the self.
Atma.
Right. That's why in the cosmos he is called Surya Narayana. That is Narayana is the universal self. In the cell, in individual, it's called Atma. The Atma, in individual, it's called Atma Surya, the inner self, inner sun.
All right.
Okay. So, there's a macrocosmic event. Now, what happens is that macrocosmic event, Earth comes between the sun and the, Moon comes between the sun and the Earth.
Yes.
So, there's a shadow of Moon, Earth on the sun. There's a darkness. Now, this capturing of the darkness by the sun, our ancestors called Rahu and Ketu eat sun.
Oh, so it's like the mind, the moon.
Moon is covering the month, and they called it Rahu and Ketu. Demons called Rahu and Ketu eating the sun.
Who called this, Guruji?
Our ancestors. Ancestors.
Okay.
Okay. So the Grahana they knew very well. Moon is coming in between the sun and Earth. And they called two demons called Rahu and Ketu capturing the sun during the Grahana.
Oh.
Okay. So now they brought in the concept of Rahu and Ketu in the cosmic level. That Rahu and Ketu represents the avidya or ignorance in the individual level.
All right.
Okay. So the individual level, the mind and the ignorance together shadow the Atma Surya, the self.
The mind and the
ignorance in the mind. Rahu and Ketu. Rahu and Ketu is the equivalent of avidya, ignorance.
But Prabhuji, like here, like the moon is the one who is covering. So is it like Rahu and Ketu are taking advantage of this time or?
No. Moon is the one covering. The shadow is covering the. Okay, the shadow aspect, they say Rahu and Ketu is eating the sun.
The shadow of the moon so to say covering the sun.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. So in the mental level, in the individual level, spiritual level, it is actually the mind is there shining with the sun, the Atma Surya, Atma Jyoti, and that is getting covered by the ignorance, Ajnana. Ignorance is the Rahu and Ketu, ego. It translates into ego. Okay. Now the Rahu and Ketu are two names. So you must have heard the story of Rahu and Ketu. Vishnu cut the neck of Asura and then head and body got separated out when they are drinking Amrita. Rahu is one with the head and Ketu is one of the without the head, body. Head, one with the head and another with the body.
Okay.
So ego, our ego also behaves like that. There are many people who keep on thinking but don't work, don't act.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Their only head is there but no body. Ego, body doesn't operate. They keep on worrying and thinking. Then there are some people who keep on acting anger and all
without thinking.
So that's actually a representation of ego in the human mind, Rahu and Ketu.
But I feel like majority of the humans are basically dilly-dallying between these two states. Sometimes they act without thinking, sometimes they think too much.
So that's why they're called demons. The demons and the mind together shadow the sun, Atma, the self.
Okay.
And of course, grahana in the human mind happens every day, but cosmic event is taken as an example. Right? Okay. So the whole cosmic event is this Atma Surya, the self is shadowed by the mind and ego. Okay, now and that all the solar eclipse always happens during Amavasya day or new moon day.
Mm-hmm.
New moon day is representing darkness.
Yes.
The darkness is Shiva.
Okay.
Where the moon doesn't obstruct the on full moon day, the moon is shining. Okay, full moon day shines. In dark moon day, dark Amavasya day, it is the absence of moon which makes is significant.
Correct.
The absence of moon represents the absence of mind.
Oh.
Okay. So in the absence of mind, the self shines as the awareness.
Yes.
Okay. So that way, the grahana represents the inner experience of enlightenment. It tells the process of enlightenment.
Oh, it is representing. It is. Basically depicting.
Yeah. And Amavasya is always the day for Shiva. Shiva is related to Amavasya. So Shiva is nothing but self, Atma, the consciousness.
Mm-hmm.
So in this way, the grahana or the solar eclipse is a time for contemplation on the spiritual truth, meditation.
Okay.
That's why it's auspicious, because it's you are actually physical demonstration happening in the outside.
Physical demonstration is happening outside.
In the cosmos.
Mm-hmm.
So inner truth you can realize much easily. That is the meaning. Parvakala.
That is why then it is said that you should not go out, you should not eat. Basically they are telling what not to do so that all of the time could be used for spiritual activity.
Correct. What they said is you should not eat, because if you eat you will sleep. Okay. Mm. Be aware.
Mm.
Contemplate, meditate on the inner self. Don't eat food, because if you eat food, you will sleepy.
Yes.
Then they said, take bath also. Take bath, not because it's not auspicious. Take bath so that your mind is fresh for meditation.
Correct. Correct.
So that is what solar eclipse is all about.
Okay. But Prabhuji, like in Amavasya is also considered very good for meditation. New moon, like Buddha Purnima,
yeah,
is also
so,
considered very good for meditation.
See,
but there are two opposites, no?
No, no. The Amavasya is, see, there are two opposites, okay? One is the absence of the mind, which is called Samadhi.
Okay.
Which is Amavasya.
Yes.
Illumination of the mind is called Purnima. Mind becomes fully illuminated, enlightened. See, the mind is absent, you will enter into Samadhi. The mind is present but is illuminated, it's called Purnima.
Purnima. Yeah, I mean, both lead to the same.
Both are, no, in the sense, there is two. One is inner, when you go to innermost reality, the mind is absent, the world is absent, it's Samadhi.
Correct, okay.
Okay, right? When you come back, the mind is there, present is there, world is there, but it's illuminated. You see the mind and world in a new light.
Okay.
Okay. Now you are full. Now you are complete. Just seeing the Atma, you are incomplete. Just seeing the world, you are incomplete. But seeing the world and Atma as total oneness, fullness, is called Purnima.
Oh.
Purnatva.
Ah, yes, yes.
Okay.
But when the mind is absent, then also it is completeness?
No, no, no. Mind is absent, you find the reality.
Okay.
Then
okay.
You find that world is also that reality. World is also manifestation of the reality.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why yoga day I explained very clearly today. You have to listen to that.
Okay.
Yoga actually means Vyoga.
Yes.
Yoga means union, but union is actually a separation.
Mm.
Okay? It's a very, very paradoxical. For union, you have to separate out. So if you have to unite with something, you have to always separate out with something.
Right.
For example, if you have to go to the college, you have to drop the high school.
Mm.
Right? So for that means yoga means you have to individual self has to unite with the cosmic self. Atma with Paramatma.
Mm.
Then you have to drop something. What is that you have to drop? Body and mind.
Body and mind.
Okay? Now then question comes. Ashtanga Yoga says asana, yama, niyama, asana, pranayama, pratyahara, dharana, dhyana, samadhi.
Mm.
There's even importance given to asana and pranayama also, which is body.
Yeah.
Okay, that's where actually yama, niyama, asana, pranayama, first four steps is having good strength of the body and mind.
Correct.
Okay. Pratyahara, dharana, dhyana, samadhi is the separation, vyoga.
Mm.
Okay. Why body and mind is required is because it's a vehicle has to be strong for a journey.
Right.
So the vehicle is made strengthened, then you make the journey. Pratyahara, dharana, dhyana, samadhi.
Yes, Prabhuji.
Okay.
Yeah.
I understand. That's, yes. It's actually more to that, right?
Mm-hmm.
So first is you strengthen the body and mind.
Mm-hmm.
To yama, niyama, asana, pranayama. Okay, then you do the inner journey. Then you say, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, I am pure consciousness. So you separate us from prakriti, nature.
Mm.
Okay, then how do you do? I am Brahmasmi, aham Brahmasmi, I am Shivoham.
Yes.
Okay, then it's not the end of it. Still it's incomplete. Then you come back and put on the mind also again.
Okay.
So now the mind has to be illuminated. So that in that illumination of the mind, prakriti and purusha become one.
That is why the completion happens.
So going back to the self is called Amavasya, or self recognition of self.
Mm-hmm.
Coming back to the world with the full moon is called Purnima, fullness.
Wow.
So yoga itself as first is strengthening the body mind so that you become stronger for journey, then separate dropping the body and mind, pratyahara dharana dhyana samadhi. Then coming back to the world where Prakriti and Purusha become one.
Hmm.
Now you have become whole. That's called Purnima.
So Buddha Purnima is when Gautama, the Buddha, he achieved the state.
Yeah, achieved the fullness.
Achieved the fullness. No separation, there is no two.
There is no two.
No.
Right? Oh. Even when you were to attain the Atmadnana, you may have still a feeling that Prakriti is there, nature is there.
Mm-hmm.
So the nature should disappear into oneness.
Okay.
So this is typically called Shiva and Shakti becoming one.
Yes.
So Jiva merges with Shiva, then Shiva and Shakti become one.
Yes.
That is actually complete realization. So this is actually International Yoga Day.
Now it makes complete sense.
Now I told about International Father's Day also, the real meaning of International Father's Day on the spiritual sense.
Okay.
See, we call father as Pitra Devo Bhava, Matra Devo Bhava, Acharya Devo Bhava, right? So Deva means actually light. So we offer our respects to light in the mother, light in the father, and light in the guru. What is that light? That is the spiritual light, Atma Jyoti. Atma Jyoti is Shiva. So we have a physical father, biological father, who gave birth to us, who took care of us. So today is a day to respect the biological father for the sacrifice he has done. At the same time, it is the biological father is the light in him, which is divine light, Atma Jyoti, which is Shiva, which is the universal father,
right,
the spiritual father. So today is a day for offering respect to the spiritual father also.
Okay.
So this is a Father's Day.
Together combined, they are just looking them in a combined perspective.
It's only one perspective. Our perspective is only Atma.
Yes, that's true, Prabhuji. I think yes, I've got the answer.
Okay.
Yes, Prabhuji. Okay.
So, shall I disconnect the call?
Yeah, we can stop the recording or disconnect. Yes. Okay.